Our lives aren't easy. I find the long separations from my family, often 7 or 8 months of the year, the hardest thing. It's not funny to get a phone call telling me the children are sick and there's nothing I can do about it. Altogether, I spend about 300 days in the saddle, an average 65 miles per day. I've ridden in the Giro 9 times and won it twice, in 66 and 69.
The 9th stage today could see one of the decisive moments of the Giro. 12 miles before the finish lies the dangerously steep climb up the 4,550-foot Monte Carpegna.
A touch of wheels there at the back brings 2 or 3 riders down. It's not unusual for this sort of thing to happen, but they're all right and they'll all be back in the race in a matter of minutes.
The riders are allowed to hold on to their team cars in an emergency. As long as the judges can see, they're not overdoing it.
And still the riders are receiving treatment as a result of that crash, and Pisani here is complaining about not having the right gears, and a lot of the big boys are a bit upset because the gradients are steeper than was originally said on the stage, and they're getting a bit edgy about it, and that edginess has resulted in another crash. We've had about 20 riders come off now, and there are wheels and bikes all over the place, and everybody's scrambling for fresh wheels as a result of punctures and new machines as well.
The leaders reach Carpegna at a fast pace and tightly bunched. They now face the 5-mile climb to the top of Monte Carpegna and then the steep drop to the finish.
112 miles gone of this 9th stage, and Fuente, as expected, has made a break and taken a clear lead. Second on the climb is number 1, Eddy Merckx, in hot pursuit of Fuente, but losing ground and is already 1/2 minute behind.
Immediately at the 107 mile mark. spectators please refrain from pushing the riders? This is strictly forbidden by the rules of the Giro, and the riders you're trying to help will in fact be penalized. Please do not push the riders.
And it's number 91 again, Fuente-first at the summit, and he takes his second mountain prize. Second, but more than a minute behind him, is number one himself, Eddy Merckx.
The 5 mile descent from Monte Carpegna. Merckx has the advantage on this stretch because of his greater weight and his skill on curves. Can Fuente keep his overall lead?
And conditions are terrible now. It's raining hard, it's misty, the road is slippery, but Fuente is still going all out on the descent. Despite these atrocious weather conditions, there's a vast crowd here greeting Fuente as he comes in to take this stage from Macerata to Carpegna. Jose Manuel Fuente crosses the line, increases his lead slightly overall, I should think. We're waiting to see who's second. It was Merckx at the summit of the mountain, and Merckx seems to have come down like a lion. There he is, pedalling every revolution, counting as he comes in, but he's 1 minute, 4 seconds down on Fuente at the line.
Fuente has now stretched his overall lead to 1 minute 40 seconds, but there are still 13 difficult stages ahead.